Nature doesn't know the distinction between chemistry, physics, math. Nature just operates. And so the philosophy that I try to take to the work is not worrying so much about what discipline this belongs to, but rather coming at nature on its own terms, which is just to say, how does this work? My name is Cliff Brangwynne, and I'm a biophysicist and an engineer. I use ideas from engineering and physics to understand the organization inside of living cells. Organelles are the substructures of the cell. Traditionally, people have thought about organelles as being exclusively assembled by membrane-bound structures. Over the last decade or so, it's become appreciated that there are many organelles that are not membrane-bound. They're open dynamic assemblies of biomolecules. So understanding how these structures work is really essential for understanding biological processes. All the important things that happen in biology, cell division, regulation of genes, cell migration, all of these processes are associated with different types of membraneless assemblies, membraneless organelles. What we are excited about is how these concepts from material science and soft matter physics can give us insights into how those structures form and what they're doing in terms of their biological function and in some cases dysfunction. In 2009, we showed for the first time that the idea of liquid-liquid phase separation was applicable to understanding these types of structures in living cells. We showed that certain types of membraneless organelles behave as liquids. They behave as condensed states of biomolecular matter. And we realized many, many different types of structures, many different aspects of biology are touched upon by this process of liquid-liquid phase separation. And so we developed a set of tools that use light to control the molecular interactions and trigger the condensation inside of living cells. And we can do things like turn the light off and ask, does this liquid dissolve? What does that mean for the function that's associated with the proteins that we've induced to condense into that liquid state? One of the things that we're particularly interested in is the relationship between liquid phase condensation and the genome. So the genome is sort of the software of the cell, if you think of the cell as a kind of computer. And so these condensed liquids are sort of like dewdrops sitting on the software, and they're impacting the way in which genes are read, the way in which genes are turned off and on. The thing that's most exciting about the MacArthur is this idea that my work is being honored alongside artists and poets and dancers and so forth. I like that a lot because that's how I've always viewed our work, as being at the creative edge. And science is just as creative a discipline as any of those.